Hello viewers, welcome to my channel IITJEE Olympiad and AP Physics with Ambarish. And today I have brought in this video another exciting challenge for all of you. And the title of the challenge is Life of Pi Returns. So here's the challenge. A tiger begins to chase a deer along a circular path on a floating uniform disk as shown. It is finally able to catch the deer after n full circular laps in a circle of radius r. It eats the deer and then just sits there. Find the net angle through which the disc rotated in the process until it is at rest again. The viscous drag is proportional to the absolute velocity of the disc points. That is, force is minus kV, where V is the velocity of the local point and F is the force on a local patch. The disc can freely pivot about a thin frictionless fixed vertical axis. Everything was still before the beginning of the chase. And treat tiger and the deer as point masses. So here we have initially the tiger is still, the deer is still, and the disc is still, and the tiger begins to chase the deer and the deer runs for his life, and that's why the tiger is not able to catch the deer in a single lap. It is able to catch after n full circular laps. Okay, and we have to find that in the process through what angle does the disc rotate on the hole. So if you want, you can try out this challenge for 5 to 10 minutes and then you can see the solution right after this. All right, let's get to the solution. So look here. So now consider, suppose this is the bottom of the disc. You are considering the bottom of the disc, and at any instant the disc is rotating with some angular velocity omega, let's say. And you consider some element on the disc, let us say this area is dA on the bottom surface, which is rubbing against water. And let's say its position vector with respect to the center of the disc is r. So now you know that the force on this is proportional to omega r, because velocity of this is omega r. So force is proportional to omega r, and that means what? The torque is proportional to omega r, and then you multiply by another r, omega r square. Okay, so that's what I've written. Since here the force is proportional to velocity, we can say that the viscous torque is also proportional to the angular velocity. So d tau is minus k omega r dA. Okay, because omega r is the velocity and dA is, if you want, you can multiply by another r, so it will become minus k omega r square dA. Not very important for this problem, even if you put an r square over there. So we can say that viscous torque, that means what? Viscous torque will be proportional to omega. That's what I am interested in, that the viscous torque is proportional to instantaneous omega. Okay, and this is the important fact that I am going to use, and that's very clear from this figure. All right, now what else can I say? So the angular impulse of viscous torque is simply proportional to the total angle through which the disc rotates. Why? Because the torque is proportional to omega, and if you integrate this, you know that integral of omega dt is nothing but the total angle through which the disc turns. So we can say that angular impulse h viscous is equal to c times theta, where theta is the total angle through which the disc has turned. Simply by integration of this, we can say that. Okay, so viscous torque is directly proportional to the angle through which the disc has turned. What else we can say? Now let's say HF be the angular impulse of friction. Why? Because when the tiger is running and the deer is running, they are also experiencing a dry friction under their feet from the disc. So therefore there is some dry friction impulse that's acting on the tiger and the deer. So I'm calling that combined dry friction impulse as HF, and the reaction of that impulse is acting on the disc. So whatever is the angular impulse in the tiger plus deer system, the negative of that is the angular impulse on the disc. Why? Because it forms an action and reaction pair, right? So let HF be the combined angular impulse of frictional forces acting on the deer and the tiger considered together. Then the angular impulse of the dry frictional forces on the disc must be minus HF. Okay, why minus? Because it's just the reaction of that, right? Now let's keep these things in mind. Viscous torque is proportional to omega, and HF is the impulse, friction impulse on the deer plus tiger, and its negative is on the disc. And now we are ready for the solution almost. So now we apply the angular impulse momentum theorem. So you know that initially the tiger and deer are at rest, and finally when the whole action has completed and the disc is coming to a standstill, once again the tiger is at rest with the deer in its tummy. Okay, so that means what? The change in angular momentum of the deer plus tiger system is zero. So net friction angular impulse must be 0. So we can say that angular impulse of friction is equal to delta L of the tiger plus deer, which is equal to 0. This is my equation 1. What else I can say? Now, the disc has also come to a standstill. That means what? Net angular impulse on the disc must also be 0. So what is the angular impulse on the disc? So friction angular impulse is minus HF and plus viscous angular impulse is HV, and we on the previous slide we showed that HV was proportional to theta directly. So we can say that minus HF plus C theta is also 0. From above we can say HF is 0, and here we can say minus HF plus C theta is also 0. And now your mind is racing directly to the answer. Using these two equations we can very easily see that the total angle, net angle through which the disc has turned is 0. So that was the challenge, and I hope all of you learned the solution. And if you did like this video, please remember to subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. If you're a student, you can share it with your peer group, and if you're a teacher, you can share it with your students, whichever students you think that might benefit from this video. Please do share it with all the people who might benefit from this video, and do give it a thumbs up. So that's for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.